Hi guys, welcome back to the First Place Auto Part Shop. My name is David, and today in the shop we are taking a look at disc brake proportioning valves to better understand what they do and what your options are when it comes time to buy your four-wheel disc brake conversion kit. The original brake systems that were designed for the 1960s and 70s GM, Ford, and Mopar muscle missiles that roamed the highways back in the day are 50 plus years old now and no match for today's hyper-paced traffic and mega horsepower pro touring muscle cars. When you add the combination of wider wheels, super sticky tires, or 550 horsepower that many of our classic Camaros, Chevelles, or Novas have been armed with, and the stock, ill-maintained brake system becomes inadequate at best and dangerous at worst. The unsung hero of your brake system and the brains behind it is the brake proportioning valve. And the proportioning valve is typically located either at or just below the master cylinder. Before we can further understand what a proportioning valve does, the first thing we have to do is get some terminology straight. We get a lot of questions about proportioning valves, and the one misconception that we find is that people tend to think that every block on a GM brake system line is a proportioning valve, and that's just not the case. The first component that we're going to take a look at is the actual proportioning valve itself, which has the job of restricting the amount of brake pressure that is sent to the rear of a brake system under heavy or severe braking. A common ratio or brake bias for a proportioning valve is to distribute 60% of its pressure to the front brakes and 40% pressure to the rear brakes. The reason there's a different brake bias for the front and rear brakes is that as that load transfer takes place under heavy braking and that weight plants those front tires on your vehicle, they have more traction at that point while the rears have less traction. If we had a 50-50 bias towards the front and the rear brake system, what would happen is the rear wheels would lock up under heavy braking, creating for some very sketchy handling. The next product we want to take a look at is called the distribution block. A distribution block has a job of distributing brake fluid to the different brake lines in a brake system and typically has a failure warning switch in the event of a half system brake failure. For example, if your rear brakes go out, this switch will identify that there's a loss of brake pressure, and typically the dummy light on your dash or the brake light on your dash will come on if that takes place, giving you at least a heads up that something's wrong. The distribution block has no effect on controlling brake bias and is simply a block where one line splits into two or more brake lines. The next component that we want to talk about is called a hold-off valve. And these were found on many, but not all vehicles that originally had a front disc and a rear drum brake setup. And what this valve does is it holds pressure off the front brakes up to a certain brake pressure point. The delay or hold in pressure to the front brakes allows the brake pressure to overcome the mechanical spring tension that is found in all rear drum brake setups and results in a better front to rear brake balance at low brake pressure. Okay, so the next part we want to talk about is the combination valve. From 1971 through 77, GM went a different direction on its cars with front disc brakes and incorporated the three valves into one combination valve, not only for better performance, but also a reduction in hydraulic connections that could have led to leaks and ultimately warranty claims. Because these type of valves tend to be, whether it's a combination or a proportioning valve, tend to be very visible right beneath the master cylinder, we offer these valves in two different types of finishes. One is a traditional brass finish. This would be correct for your car when it was made new. The other is a chrome version, which tends to accentuate other chrome pieces under your hood, whether it be a valve cover, air cleaner, or even a master cylinder. We offer these in two different finishes, so you can customize however you'd like. If you're doing a four-wheel conversion kit, make sure you get the right proportioning valve with your kit. So when you buy a four-wheel conversion kit, the best thing to do is get the most complete one you can find. To find more restoration and performance parts like these, go to our First Place Auto Parts website, which is always open and easy to use at fpautoparts.com. Follow us on Facebook and YouTube, where we'll continually be adding new product video reviews and also how-to install videos that may be a benefit to you when it comes time to buying or installing the parts on your car. Until next time, keep the hammer down and keep it between the guardrails.